Hi everyone, welcome to Google Developers Live. Today we're going to be talking about searching for files using the Google Drive API. Now Google, obviously we do search, hopefully we do it well. That's no exception with Google Drive. So I'm just going to open my Google Drive now and show you what it looks like for the user, and then we'll do that for a couple of minutes and then we'll go on to how it is for the developer. So I've pre-created a couple of files here, fruits and vegetables and fruits and vegetables PDF. Let's have a look at one of them. So the first one is just a list of some fruits and vegetables. I want you to notice a couple of things. The first one is the title is fruits and vegetables. And secondly, there's a list: banana, apple, orange, pear, lemon, mango, cucumber. Now, what I did earlier was I exported this file as a PDF, except it's not the whole file. I created just five fruits in there first and then exported that. So this is actually a PDF, also in Google Drive. And this has only got banana, apple, orange, pear, lemon, and it's got a similar kind of title. Okay, so if I go to Google Drive and if I search for banana, I find lots of stuff. Actually, I like bananas. But one of them is this, fruitsandvegetables.pdf. We see we open that. So interesting to see, Google Drive has scanned that PDF and it knows the contents, so that when you type one of the textual content in this binary file, it looks it up for you and it finds it. So that's great. And it found our other one as well. Here it is, fruits and vegetables. Okay. Now, if I just search for one of the terms that's only in the Google Doc, not in the PDF, so that's going to be cucumber here. Just want you to see, we only get the one file. Obviously, that's how it works. So that's the general flow for the user. So Google Drive API aims to be able to do anything the user can do in Google Drive, be able to do it via a programmatic interface, the Google Drive API. So let's switch immediately to our Python shell and let's have a try on that. So this is bpython. I've got the Python client library installed and I've got an authorized HTTP instance ready to be imported. That's just saving us a couple of minutes of time. So first thing we're going to do is import the HTTP instance that's got authorization. That's in my library called auth that I can share with you if anyone's interested. Secondly, I want to create a drive instance. This is standard for you all. Oh, let's import from apiclient.discovery, import build, and drive, which is going to be our drive service, drive equals build, then the name of the API, and the version of the API. This goes off to the discovery service, finds the schema for this API, and builds a service dynamically in Python that can use that. And let's not forget to use our authorized HTTP instance, so we don't need to pass that every time on every call. So let's create that and let's make sure we've got something. So drive, there it is. Now, when you want to search files in the Google Drive API, you can apply a query to any list operation involving files. So that's really files.list or children.list. You can apply these queries. We're just going to use files.list for now, and we're going to create some queries to see. So the first one I'd like to do is the basic query that we just did. So we're going to search for banana or apple or something like this. So drive.files.list. So we could just run that for now and that would list all of them. But by passing the Q parameter is one of our query, is a query created by whatever parameters you want. Let's just have a quick look at these parameters in our documentation. So these are the fields available: title, full text, mime type, modified date, last viewed by me date, trash starred, hidden, parents. So all of these, you can see them, and that's in our documentation, developers.google.com/drive, and under the tag of search parameters. That's where you can find that. So we have these parameters. We also have some operators, depending on how you want to apply it, in for collections, contains for strings within other strings, equals obviously is equality, less than and greater than for dates. And you can combine these terms with and you can negate these terms with not. So that's pretty much whatever you want to do. So back to the shell. So we want to say, okay, we want fruit in the title, for example. So I'm going to use double quotes here because the query language uses single quotes. So fruit and the field title contains fruit. How about that? So we'll do that and we'll execute it. And we see loads of stuff. Okay, so this just shows us that we've found a search. It's not an empty result. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to write a quick function to be able to run these queries and return us more useful information that fits on a page. Okay, so we're going to call it execute query. And it's going to take a query that we'll call Q. That will be a string that's passed in. And what's it going to do? Well, let's have a look. Items equals drive.files.list. Q equals Q dot execute. Let's grab the items dict. That will be a list of items that have been returned. Okay. So, and then let's just print the length of that. We don't really want to see all the individual items. So print length result found. And a full stop to be good. And let's just test that out. So execute query. And let's do the same one. So fruit title contains fruit. Title contains fruit. Here's where it doesn't work. There we go, two results found. So those are our two files, and that's great. So let's play about with that. So we had title. Title here is the field that we're going to be looking for. So if you want to search within the full text, then you just say full text equals fruit. Okay, and full text obviously includes the title and the body of the file itself. So we found our two results. Now let's do the query for a type of fruit that we know is in the body. So let's try banana. And we know there are more results. There were eight. Remember, we found those eight results earlier. And let's do a mango that is only in the doc and not in the PDF. And there you go. It's only in one result found. So what I really want to show you here is that it's treating PDFs, and it does the same for images that have text in them. It's treating them as if they're plain text files or text files that can be indexed. Massively useful. Essentially doing OCR on your stuff and being able to return the results with the queries that you provide. So that's that one. And there are other query parameters. So we're going to do a few, and we're going to show you a few more operators. So MIME type, that's a pretty cool one. So you can query by MIME type. I just want MIME type equals... And let's think of an easy one to type, application PDF. So these are going, this is all the PDFs in my Google Drive. That's 22 results. Okay, it's pretty great. Another thing we can do is we can look at the parent hierarchy. So I can say, I want files that are only within a certain directory. Okay, so let's do another query here. So let's say I want files that are in the root directory. Now, root is a special alias for the base directory, you know, in your Google Drive. And so this means files that are in that and not in any other folders. So root in parents. And we got six results. So if we go back to Google Drive, we can see that... there are others there. So it's looking at these four and a couple of others that I've hidden away. So that's that. So that's the parents. And again, we can look at in children, which looks at which files that are children of the folder. So we have that case covered. Combining these, that's pretty cool. You can combine these as well. So you can say root in parents and full text contains mango. Okay, that should return one result, and it has done there. So this is looking for files that are in the root directory and the full text contains mango. And you can just combine these. So let's see, and not full text contains mango. So this wants stuff in the root directory that is not containing the word mango. And we see the six files there. Okay, so using this, you can combine these search queries. We also have a few little tweaks here and there that we've added to make the stuff more useful. One thing we just launched yesterday, actually, is a query that people have been asking for on Stack Overflow, and I think something very, very useful. It's called shared with me. So that's the complete query, is you just execute shared with me. And that returns files in the Google Drive that have been shared with me. If you wanted to do that query otherwise, you'd have to say, well, I'm not the owner of the file, but I am in the readers or I am in the writers, something like that. You'd have to create that query and it's not exactly perfect and people have been having trouble. So we've just launched this, shared with me, and that returns those 28 results. Really, really useful if you want to separate what your files are and what someone else's files are, which leads me to searching for permissions on files. So you can say, I want files where I am a writer. So you would say me, and that is another alias for my username, but I can just put afshar@gmail.com in writers. So these are files that I can write to. I have the permission to write to. And there we go, 99 results. Actually, it's bigger than that. 99 is the page size. So if you wanted the next set of pages, you do that. And these files are all my images. I have thousands of images in my Google Drive, photographs. So this is just looking at them. Again, if I do readers, we should again get 99 results. That's all the files I can read. And the last one is owners. Okay, and that's going to take a bigger query and it's taking a bit of time. 100 results found. So let's combine this query with the shared with me query to see what happens. So this is files which are shared with me and I'm an owner of. That's quite an interesting case. It means someone has shared me the file and made me the owner of it. Zero results, okay? It's not going to happen very often that someone shares you a file and makes you an owner. It's more likely they'll share the file, allow you to write or comment on it or read it, but maintain ownership in there for themselves. Okay, so that's searching. As I say, we've got documentation here. We have a number of examples that I encourage you to try. Title equals hello, mime type we showed you, title contains, negation we showed you, using the full text, which is the body and the description and the title. We showed you how to search by permission, as in using in writers, in readers. We showed you how to test for the parent hierarchy, as in using the in parents query. We showed you how to combine queries together using the and operator, and we showed you how to negate queries with the not operator. I see at the end we've got just one more query, which is the date style queries, and that's where you can use greater than, less than, greater than or equal to specify what the relationship is with the date. So greater than a date is means after a date. Kind of makes sense. So hang on, let's just copy paste that query and run it. Execute query. Oops. So this is going to look for files with a modified date after the 4th of the 6th this year. And that's going to be a lot. 100 results found. Let's find files that modified before then. That might be zero actually. I think I cleaned out my Google Drive. Oh no, that's more as well. So I do have some old files and some new files. Let's put an earlier date in here so we can kind of get this, I don't know, 2007. There you go. So no files in my drive were modified before then. Okay. As usual, we're keen to get you up and running on this. If you find something you want to search for that you can't do immediately, if you find that any particular queries are slow, these are things we really need to know about. So please let us know. Let us know on Stack Overflow. I'm always available. You can contact me on Google Plus or on Gmail. Things we absolutely, absolutely need to know about. If you find anything good or you want something expanded, also let us know. Okay. So that's searching in the Google Drive API. Thank you very much, and we look forward to hearing from you.